You would have better win a Swanizard 2. Welcome back to Pokemon Axis. You can see the link in the description for the first episode. This is a funny fan game. Not funny. This is a pretty good game. So we're in another world. We're in another dimension pretty much. And we're just chilling out. Our starter is this thing. It's like a fallen... What do you call this thing? Chimchar. And it's a psychic type. And yes, it should be evolved. These dudes have like birth signs, which we'll check out in a second. But we just beat the first gym leader, so let's get out of here. The next gym is in Ichuki Town. It's kind of fast-paced, so this game seems pretty cool. Oh, it's Marina. So she's the granddaughter of the professor. Well, here you are, Wang. What are you doing here in Imogi Town? Wait, did you just beat this gym? But you only got your Pokemon earlier. You must be a natural. Right. I'm asking people more about the Pokemon attacks that have been happening recently. Okay, I know some information, Marina. Ask me. To get straight to the point, there's not enough people here to gather any information. A lot of them got scared away by the Pokemon attacks. What? You met some people who threw a file and controlled the Pokemon? So yeah, it was a vial of like some sort of berserk thing and it made the Pokemon go crazy. And so I caught it. I think I was supposed to kill it though. That's rather disturbing actually, but it's a lead. Hmm. Asking around here is kind of risky. People are afraid of disappearing. We can ask around at the bar though. Yes, I know we're not old enough to drink. Just come on. I'll go with you. Oh, Big Wang over here. The barkeeper has some information you might like to hear. So, I think we're strong because we talked to Arceus in the beginning. I feel like maybe that boosts us a bit. Well, I only heard recently, but my niece up in Salinas City has disappeared. I'm sorry to hear that. That's okay. I'm sure it is. I'm sure she'll turn up eventually. No one reacts like this. But still, there's some stuff that happened before she disappeared. She and my daughter were close. Oh, her niece, his niece and his daughter. They used to send each other letters, but the most recent ones were disturbing. You read them? Talks of shadows following her and whispery voices, stuff like that. Can you tell us any more than that? No, but my daughter still has the letters. You can try asking her. Still, Marina, I didn't expect you to be investigating ghost stories. Sounds like her active imagination playing up. But if you want to look into it, go right ahead. We live in the house in the southeast corner. You go ahead. All right, I'll go. I'm not talking to these drunks. What? That's a rude word to say. But they're drunk. It's this. Hello? Tell me some ghost stories. That's not your name.
What's that? Dad said to come and look at the letters from Hina. You want to find out what happened to her? Hang on, I'll go get the letters.
I'll find her.
Hey you, come over here.
Hey, he's working at the bar, leave me alone.
I know you just want to help, but just don't give her too much false hope, okay? Hina disappeared almost a month ago. It'd be a miracle if she was still alive after this long.
I thought the game glitched. What did she just tell me? So what's our theories? She is either dead, let's not say that. She could be, like, a part of Team Void now, the evil team, like the anti-Arceus team. Or, she could be mind controlled. I guess those are three options. Or she just kidnapped. Just stuck somewhere, roped up.
Is Mom giving you all the nonsense about giving up again? Nara, you know I'm just worried about you. You have an unhealthy obsession with this. This isn't about me, it's about Hina. Nara placed the letters down. You start reading. Dear Nara, it's still happening. I can always see them there, just out of the corner of my eye. The shadows. I'm getting more and more concerned about this. They seem to just be targeting me. They follow me every day when I leave the trainer school, and I can hear the voices. They're terrifying. They say things like, join us. We can feel your soul slipping. Oh my god.
Why am I so concerned?
When I'm old enough to get a Pokemon, hope I can fight back against this. I'm so scared, Hina. You see? That's why I want to go up to Salinas City myself and investigate, but Mom won't let me because she's worried. You'll investigate in my place? Thank you. You can get there from the west of Catlett Town. Oh, you have a gym badge. The Pokemon gets more items.
This is really cool, guys. The mystery is adding up for this game. You're getting like a really cool incentive to keep going on, and it's kind of fast-paced. We haven't had any like Viridian Forest or Rock Tunnel that you have to spend like an entire episode at. We've just been breezing through a lot of plot. It's kind of fun. By the way, my bong died. It was a Bidoof, so we're gonna put you in the death box. Alright, there we go. So let's put our bong in the broken bong box. Very cool. So one thing we can check out is this right here. Before we go there, we can go right now. We're totally out of potions. Let me quickly stock up. Wow, we did not get as much money as I thought. That's Someone give me money. This sucks. I have no money. Why'd I freaking choose to Nuzlocke this? Okay, so our Pokemon have these things called Lunacy. And it's birthmarks, birth signs. Some sort of like power from when they were born. Or like, you know, when the stars align and crap. Some sort of mystical power. Lunacy. Activate Changa's birth sign? Yes. Using this power will lower Changa's level by 3! No! Oh my god, so they go Super Saiyan, but they lose levels? That is freaking badass. We gotta check that out later. The Fishing Brothers, let's get a fishing rod. I heard about this. Okay. Also guys, thank you so much for all the love on this. You guys have been smashing like on this. So I'm continuing it. It seems like a very fun game. I'm glad you guys are enjoying it. The boatyard. Alright, let's take a boat. The shipyard is locked. Houdini, open this. You two lovers. Oh, Jack. Get these dudes away from the boat. What? It's not the Titanic. It's freaking a boat. Oh my god, Mallow Milk. Oh, hey. You're interested in the Pokemon attacks? I've been doing some research, too. Can I use your boat? I'm investigating the recent attacks. If you're interested, look downstairs. He's gonna kidnap me. Oh, you're interested in my investigations? I'm freaked out by this dude. Oh, nice. What are we looking at here? Pictures of Pokemon attacking people from the sea. Their eyes appear to be blacked out. Okay, so they've gone berserk because of the vials. From what I've found so far, most attacks occurred with a similar pattern. This is really cool. The pattern is, there's usually one or multiple individuals wearing black and yellow outfits in the area at the time. It's almost like they're the cause of this, but that can't be right. So I went into some calculations and figured out that one thing is certain. They're organized attacks, but sadly that's all I know, so far at least. Hey, not bad, dude. This is the weirdo. This dude's got all the rope tied around crap. Not one meme. Yeah, it's me. They're exactly like you said they'd be. I did the job. Yes, yes, ma'am. I'll leave it to you then. The sucker. I can't believe I know he's evil and I can't do anything about it. He's freaking working for them. I'm just surprised I'm not missing. The sucker could have kidnapped me. So, what is this thing about these shadows that are following people? That's kind of kooky. Like, what I was thinking is that it's just the Team Void people sneaking up on people. But this is like some actual, like, you're tripping out and seeing stuff. Oh, dude. Oh, guy appears to be sleeping. Alright, let's go through his history. Okay, I stole from his 3D printer. Tunes guitar, totally rad stuff back there. Maybe we can catch up a bit later. Alright, can I go into your room? Oh my god, I can now. Ooh. Her prized bass guitar. It's a Pokeball, there's a note to the side. Hello there, nosy trainer wandering around my room. First off, get out. Secondly, this Rockruff needs a new home. That is so cute. First off, get out. I'll take it. I got the big wang received the Pokemon from Darlene. That's kind of cool because it's a rock type. Wait, what did it say? Transmute. Oh my god, it's got Fire Fang. That's kind of nice. That's a nice addition to my team. Can I sleep in your bed now? Hey, I found where to go. We have to go back to the first town. Hey, wait up. I thought that was you, Wang. I was hoping you'd do me a little favor. Battle me with that Pokemon Grandpa gave you. That's right, I'm challenging to a battle. Nothing wrong with a little healthy competition, right? Let's do this. Oh my god, Marina. Stop looking at me like that. What the hell? So, if I evolve this Chimchar, what's its second type mean? It's supposed to be fire and then fire fighting. It's a psychic type. You just kill yourself. No, that's not. I'm getting the wrong kind of experience here. She picked the Turtwig. Okay. The Turtwig is dark. Oh, frick. This is kind of cool. I should have switched out. So, what is Changa gonna become? From psychic to. Is that Turtwig a freaking ghost type? Dark ghost? Alright, killed with baby. Let's see. Predict what typing Changa. I don't know his name. Changa. Well, I guess I need to keep training. What typing will he become? I'm gonna let him. So far, your silhouette looks fine. Your Chimchar looks like a freaking NF something hat, helmet wearing. He's got a Santa hat on. Santum. This sucker is psychic ground. It is so fun. It's pretty good. I like the starter I chose. Those are two really good offensive types. And I guess pretty good defensively. Man, you're tough for a rookie. We evolved it, guys. I should have known I wouldn't be able to match up to you. After all, you have a gym badge already. You could get it too. Just remember to heal your Pokemon when it gets low, okay? Alright, I wanted to give you this. A love note! I knew it! It's a cool communication device my aunt made. It has a map by default, but you can get more stuff on the go. So, you talked to the barkeeper's daughter, right? What did she say? Alright, she said to go to that Ikebugu area. Ghost following her around. Usually that isn't enough for people to go missing. We'll have to go up there and investigate further. But oh, it must have been a while since anyone went this way. Just look at those trees. Usually in times like these, we need an HM. Here, have this. You go on ahead. Yeah, this is the way to go. Thanks for almost... She's still here. I see her. Hey. Okay, I'm gonna pretend like I don't. Alright guys, I taught gun, rocks, cut. Now we can go through here. Route 2. New encounter, guys. Route 2. Okay, let's get it. Hello. I'm probably a beast now. Yes! I'm so much stronger after evolving. I gotta let my other Pokemon level up though. This is a good opportunity for my gun. Get my gun leveled up. Yes, look at that experience. My gun hit level 10 and is trying to learn Bite. Okay. Where's my encounter? So many trainers. This leads to Salinas City. Alright, this is where we gotta go. There's something to bugs I like. There's the cave. Why do people always make fun of my name? Logber. Don't worry, man. I got a gun, too. Oh my god, guys. Grass was just super effective on me. I did not even put that together. I'm a ground type, so I'm weak to grass now. Okay. That's kind of scary. I do like these offensive typings, though. This does not answer the question. Bing, bing, bing. There's the cave. Alright, I'm gonna go heal up, but I want to get my encounter, so let's get our encounter. Come on, how did I not find it this entire time? What's over here, a game-breaking glitch? Alkyon's town? My lord. Another one of you? Oh, you're a trainer, right? Heading to all the cities and getting badges, whatever? Cool, I have a favor to ask. I have this letter to give to my brother in Salinas. I'd have sent it myself, but the mail pelipper hasn't been coming often. The bro's letter. What if your bro's been, like, inducted into all that crap? I'm playing a game with my friends in Dragtown. Maybe you'll meet them on your travels. That's something I was expecting in the real world. The world we came from? In a Pokemon world? Why are you doing this? I'm just looking for a healing spot. Where the frick am I? She's sleeping. That's cute. I thought she was dead. I'm like, that's not very cute. Now it's cute. Watch. I can go upstairs. She's a gym leader, this lady! We have to come here, lady. Okay, let's not... We have to come here, lady? Later. But hold on. Let's read her diary. A book documenting different birth signs. Who... You're so cute. Wow, a guest. Hello there. Jeez, I'm not ready to receive guests at all. Hi, I'm Lyra. Oh my god, it's the parent in between the daughter and... Oh, shoot. I'm Lyra Kanzen. Oh, you have a Pokedex. You must have met my dad then. Not that he appreciates me all that much at all after I called his research stupid. I'm not gonna lie, this game actually has me intrigued. They're doing a good job. Anyway, what brings you down here to my abode in Alkyon? Just a look around. Well, I can assure you, my star observatory is well equipped to sate your curiosity. If I had some work colleagues, anyway. What do we do here, you ask? Well, a long time ago, I found an old story about how Pokemon in this region are affected by a trait called birth signs.
I'm curious about this. After a bit of research, I found that these birth signs are in fact quite real. The bulk of it is that depending on what month the Pokemon is born under, it gets a different birth sign based on a constellation. Now, until now, they just seemed to be aesthetic and didn't really bring much to the table. However, I realized that some birth signs actually grant changes, like some increase the chances of a Pokemon hatching into a boy or a girl, or even grant skills that can heal the party of status effects, with a health cost though. So, as you can tell, these effects can be really beneficial to the average trainer. But wait, there's more. I was traveling and came across a rare orb, and it reacts to Pokemon with a certain birth sign. All this mysterious stuff with birth signs gets my blood pumping. Look at her. All this stuff is so cool, and who knows what else birth signs can do. So I made notes, which is what that book in front of you is. Well, those were the initial notes anyway. I made a more detailed account on my PC. Oh hey, you have a Pokenote. My niece must have given that to you then. Okay. So she has a brother or sister, this girl right here. And that's the father of the girl. She only really gives those out to people she considers a friend. I actually gave her that though. Whatever. I could do you a favor and give you an app for it. That documents my research on different birth signs and their effect. However, you need to give me a hand with something. As you can see, this place is so dead, it makes Aerodactyl look common. I need more enthusiastic people, so if you find anyone like that during your travels, give them a nudge towards me, yeah?
Yeah, I'll help you. So she's like a abandoned professor who's the daughter of the big professor. I kind of like that. She's doing her own thing here, and she doesn't like her dad. And she's an astronomy lover. I wish I could see the stars. That was really good. Because she was sleeping and I woke her up by looking at her book. So there's more things to look at here. I swear I could go on that balcony there, but I just wanted to heal my Pokemon and head back. It's a nice little peaceful town. She's even living in a town instead of a full-on city. Erebus Cavern. Alright, encounter. That looked like an unknown. Dude, I'm tired of rock types. Do you have sturdy? I would use cut if you did. Dude, I don't even want a rock and roll. Rip. I got myself a rip. I'm training in this ragged cave. Get me out of this cave. I also like how we're helping her out. Because your actions in this game changed the game, I forgot. That's really what we figured out in the first episode. But that's more of a side quest. We're gonna run into situations where we have to make the right choice. It's gonna be cool. I wonder if Dialga and Palkia will play a role in this game. I'm curious. Okay, simple cave.
Bruh.
Too scared to talk to things. You're special.
I'm searching for a rare item that was said to be hidden around here.
Alright, I'm gonna find it.
Ooh, it said...
Your map is upside down, bum bum.
Searching far and wide for this item.
Dude, it's probably right here. Dude. Oh, I found a rare bone. Oh, wow. You gotta come here much later in the game. What is she doing here? Oh, she's a trainer. I just want to get out of this cave. Guys, I did so much training and my game froze. I'm gonna smack someone's ass and call it a day. My own ass.
Granny, I'm paying respect to the people who got trapped in here under rubble many years ago. An incident. Those poor souls.
Where are we?
I love caves, I love mountains.
Oh, I found a hole.
There's a low rumbling from behind you.
Is there like an earthquake happening?
A wild Pokemon attacks!
Alright. It's a freaking static encounter. I'll take it, a drill burr. Alright.
I caught it! Full health!
Lady, you're gonna have the most wonderful name ever. She's in the broken bongs already. We're out, guys. Route 2. Salina City. Wow.
Hey there, Wang.
Who are you? Oh, Marina, your hair is not blue anymore. Green, red.
Man, you don't hang about, do you? I can't believe you beat me here. Not that that is a bad thing, though. It might have been nice to get here first, you know? Ah, well, what's done is done.
So this is the big city, huh? It's definitely big. It's kind of overwhelming. Come on, let's go ask around for signs of Hina. I'll start at the trainer school.
Right, this is where she went missing. This is where she sent letters from.
What the frick are you poking about?
The city's enjoyably big.
Alright, and there's a gym here too.
Oh, sorry about that. You're a trainer, aren't you? And wow, already packing Darlene's badge at your age. Impressive. Gotta go now, see ya.
What the frick happened? Did my game just glitch? Dude, I have to catch this idiot again.
Get me out of here.
Oh yeah, I almost forgot. I'm Dustin, the gym leader of this town. I'll be waiting for you over there in my gym once you get three ba-
You cannot speak to me like that, sir. Three badges? This game scares me. The only thing worse than a Nuzlocke is when the game glitches. It's extreme hard mode. Okay, not as bad as extreme.
Hello, police. The perimeter is safe for now.
So I'm guessing you found nothing around town?
Well, I suppose that's to be expected. There's lots of people here. No one would notice if one individual disappeared. Anyway, welcome to the trainer school.
Alright. I was once here when I was smaller. I learned all there is to know about Pokemon.
Yeah, of course your grandpa sent you here.
I guess that just reading up on that sort of stuff doesn't help an actual battle. Real battles are way different than I expected them to be. But enough about that. We're here looking for Hina, right? Let's go ask around.
I met your aunt, by the way. She's pretty cool. I like her.
Check out this place. They must have added this after I graduated. Looks like we could have a mighty fine battle here.
Do you wanna?
What?
Alright, fine. Let's fight her.
Alright, I'll show you how much I improved.
Don't pose like that.
Alright, she has a Luxio now instead of a, whatever.
Shanks, that's pretty cool.
So I've been using Gun all throughout that cave. I got him up.
I'm like, what type could it be? It's Dark something. Looks like a Steel type. Dark Steel. And then look at this.
Sand Tomb is super effective.
I almost freaking died with that experiment. So that is a Dark Steel type.
More training required.
Oh man, you still beat me. I tried my best though.
Right, so let's ask some teachers if they know anything.
That was really cool. Oh, hello teacher. I can't get to the teacher.
All the students are restless. How about you give them all a battle? I can make it worth your while. Are you kidding me?
You want me to... Alright, I'll fight them.
That's one student down. That's two down.
Three. Four, five, and six. That was a lot of training. Look how high level my Pokemon are. Changa 21, Gun 17, and Baby 15. That's pretty good. It was worth my while.
All the students are restless. Ah, you beat them all. Good job, you can have this.
Okay. Man. That took me forever.
Alright, more rooms.
Oh, hello. Trying to be a nurse, Joy? Hina? I heard the principal knew something about her disappearing. It was crazy stuff, I tell you. Ghost stories, huh?
Yo, the principal be shady. Oh, my camera's not on. Whatever, you don't need it.
What's on the menu today?
Hina, I don't know much. Maybe the nurse will know?
Oh, one last room. The principal. Alright, camera time, boys. This dude knows.
Is it a ghost story? What are these freaking weird-ass shadowy figures?
Tell me, mister, with a lot of time on his hands.
Thank you for meeting with us, sir. My pleasure, dear. My dear, what have you come to me to talk about?
We were sent by Hina's cousin to investigate her disappearance. The nurse said you may know something.
Lavender Town? I don't trust anyone after that fat man made fun of me.
Truthfully, I'm not at all sure what happened exactly. I was watching the students leave for the day. I blinked and she disappeared from the crowd. It's possible she got mixed up in something. She did seem to be in a hurry, though. Something was troubling her.
So what happened to her, then?
I believe she simply vanished. There's nothing more to say. It's sad though. I believe she was to be a promising trainer.
She's alive somewhere out there, and she's a strong ass trainer.
Well, that doesn't leave us with much to go on, does it, Big Wang? I'm sorry it was not much help. Don't worry about it. I'm sure we'll figure something out.
Where the what? Whoa! That was sick! This game is really good. There's no filler. There's mysteries going on. Just the moment we reach a dead end, I freaking fall under it. I thought my game froze. Huh? Big Wang, where did you go? Big Wang!
No, 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 no! No more of you ghostly people! Leave me alone!
Oh my god, weirdos! Slap like, guys. We're continuing this next part if this video gets a lot of likes. Let me know if you're enjoying this. Tell me the mystery is pretty good in this game. The ongoing mystery. This is what I'm thinking. These dudes have like some sort of transmutation circle. Like devil worshippers. And they're summoning me here, but why? Actually, did she put the symbols on the ground and summon me? Or did I magically appear because of some other thing? And those symbols appear under me? Like the freaking Thor coming down and the stuff in the sand. Alright guys, let me know what you're thinking. Let's keep going. 3 episodes, we got really far. You want a little peek? You want a peek of this area? Where are we? The Ghost Realm? What the frick is going on in this game? This has me so intrigued. What does this have to do with the dream stuff as well? Alright guys, see you next episode. Peace, if we do a next episode.